Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In Flame 2019, we introduced the MasterGrade for floatpoint HDR-capable grading within the Timeline and VFX toolsets. So you could work within video, log, or linear color space, and grade the various primaries, as well as tonal values within your images. This is all covered in the first video about the MasterGrade shader. Now with the Flame 2019.1 update, the MasterGrade has now been enhanced with Rgb Curves, allowing you to have even more dedicated control when it comes to grading the colors within your image. We'll start off with an explanation of the curves, and then we'll take a look at how they work. So go ahead and load a shot into the timeline and switch to the effects environment. I am using Scene Linear material, and I'll set up the MasterGrade controls to Scene Linear. You can use any material you like, and you can work in the color toolset of your choice by going into the Controls tab and adjusting the Image Type menu. Just bear in mind that if I were to switch from Scene Linear to Log or Video mode in the middle of making adjustments, the controls will then reset themselves in the new mode, but I could use Undo to get back to the Scene Linear grade. Now, since you're about to do grading, I recommend switching to a 2-up view with Alt 2 and use one view as the result view, and the second view will be the scopes. Just click the Scopes button to display them. There is also a pull-down menu to easily access the scope presets, settings, and preferences. Now, looking at the MasterGrade controls, you have your primary controls, the tone controls, and now the curve controls. Currently, this is only RGB curves, but they have been tweaked to be high performance through GPUs, and they are also floating point capable. It's worth noting that even though Curves is the third button down in the menus, the curves are actually applied first to the image, and then the primaries, followed by the tones. This color pipeline is quite common in Luster, but is different than some other grading applications. Now, the Curves graph maps the luminance of the image from black on the left to white on the right. Using the video or log controls, this would normally be mapped from 0 to 1. In the case of working in Scene Linear, the curve is displayed in f-stop units relative to 18% middle grey. This is considered a more perceptually balanced way of editing the curve, and it is actually quite easy to make curve adjustments without zooming in and out of the curve. So for starters, you can toggle between the master curve, which is RGB together making up the luminance, and then you have the individual red, green, and blue curves. Each curve starts with 3 points, and you can click any point and move them around. Your image will instantly update, and you can also see the results in the scopes. To reset a selected curve or all the curves, just call up the contextual menu and choose one of the reset options. Now, when it comes to adding points, you can press and hold A and click points on the curve. Currently, you can have a maximum of about 30 points for all the curves. Similarly, you can press and hold D and delete the points from the curve. If you permanently enabled Add or Delete mode from the Tools menu, just press M to return back to Move mode. Now, everything is selection based, so ensure you select the curve or points before you do any operations. Now, you can control click to select multiple points, and you can also control drag a box selection. To add or remove points from an existing selection, just hold control shift and drag over the points. Once the points are selected, you can move the selection as a group. The movement of the points is free in both directions. But if you wish to constrain the movement of any selection, hold Shift first, and then drag the points horizontally or vertically. You can also use the sliders to be numerically accurate with any adjustments. If you wish to adjust the selection in small increments, you can hold Meta Shift and use the arrow keys to push a point or a group selection of points in any direction. The increments are 0.01 for video and log controls and 0.05 for scene linear controls. If you want to adjust a selection by another value, you can click on the sliders for the calculator, enter in your increment value, and click the add or subtract buttons, which will update the selection live before closing the calculator. So those are the ways to manipulate the curve. These points can also be manipulated if you're driving the MasterGrade with a tangent panel. Now let's zoom into the curve with control space and focus a bit more on the curve itself. I didn't know if you noticed, but the curve is continuous and does not have any tangents. The smoothness and monotonicity is all taken care of in the background. The mathematics keeps the control points from creating an unusable extreme curve. And you also can't drag and reorder control points in order to preserve the integrity of the curve. The ends of the curve will also extrapolate in a linear sense, and this ensures that the adjustments remain floating point friendly. Now, in terms of a workflow, as well as identifying colors within the image, curves, and scopes, you would use all these tools in combination with the color sampler. Click the eyedropper button to bring up the color sampler window. As soon as you do that, you start getting loads of sample representations in the scopes as well as in the curves. So to sample a specific pixel color, you move the box over a region of the image, and you can see the magnification in the sampler window. Looking at the curves, you will get the appropriate red, green, and blue lines indicating the colors within the image luminance. So to push the sampled color to a specific value, you could add a point on the relevant curve and adjust the value. Note that if you're looking through the result view, the color sampler will show you the new grade value in the image. This is the reason why all the sampler indications shift as you drag the curve. So that is pushing the curve to a specific color value, which is quite common. However, if you want to adjust the tone at a specific point in the curve, you would switch the result viewport to front with F1, and this always allows you to lock onto the original value through the color sampler. So you can always locate the original value on the curve and add a point at that position. When you switch back to the result view with F4 and adjust the point vertically on the curve, you are always targeting the specific value from the original image. These are the two suggested workflows for using the curves. And remember that toggling between F1 and F4 will update the sample areas, which affect the indications on the curves and scopes. You could also switch the color sampler into average mode, and depending on the size of the sample box, will affect any sample indications visible on the curves and in the scopes. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2019.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.